Please join us on page 5, the lighting of the candles. The choir's going to sing too, I hope. Good morning. Our entrance hymn is on page 147 in the liturgical books.
Worship before your throne, O King of heaven. Forgive all my sins.
O King of heaven, forgive all our sins.
Pray for me to the Lord.
May God accept your offering and have mercy on us through your prayer.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Lord Jesus, our true High Priest, make us worthy to commemorate the bishops and the priests and deacons, subdeacons, teachers who have passed from this life. They cared for your flock, served at your altars, and celebrated your mysteries. May they share the heavenly reward of the faithful bishops and the priests and deacons and subdeacons, that with them they may sing glory and thanks to you, to your Father, and to your Holy Spirit forever.
Amen.
Peace be with the church and her children.
Glory to God in the highest.
Darkness.
incense. And may the priests who have celebrated your mysteries and have departed from us receive the reward of the good and faithful servant. In the abundance of your grace, forgive their sins. And remember on your heavenly altar all the good things they offered to you. May they share the reward of your saints, and with them may we raise glory and thanks to you forever.
Amen.
Please stand. Brothers and sisters, you have not come to something that can be touched, a blazing fire, and darkness and gloom, and a tempest and the sound of a trumpet, and a voice of whose words made the hearers beg that not another word be spoken to them, for they could not endure the order that was given. Even if an animal touches the mountain, it shall be stoned to death. Indeed, so terrifying was the sight that Moses said, I tremble with fear. But you have come to Mount Zion and to the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, and to innumerable angels in festal gathering, and to the assembly of the firstborn who are enrolled in heaven, and to God, the judge of all, and to the spirits of the righteous who made perfect, and to Jesus, the mediator of a new covenant, and to the sprinkled blood that speaks a better word than the blood of Abel.
Praise be to God always.
Amen.
And your faithful shall ring out their joy.
We offer this incense and ask for your mercy, O Lord.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
From the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Luke, who proclaimed life to the world, let us listen to the proclamation of life and salvation for our souls.
Remain silent, O listeners, for the Holy Gospel is about to be proclaimed to you. Listen and give glory and thanks to the Word of the living God.
The Lord Jesus says, "Who then is a faithful and prudent manager whom his master will put in charge of his servants to give them their allowance of food at the proper time? Blessed is that servant whom his master will find at work when he arrives. Truly, I tell you, he will put that one in charge of all his possessions. But if that servant says to himself, 'My master is delayed in coming,' and if he begins to beat the other servants, men and women, and to eat and drink and get drunk, the master of that servant will come on a day when he does not expect him, and at an hour that he does not know, and will cut him in pieces and put him with the unfaithful people. That servant who knew what his master wanted, but did not prepare himself or do what was wanted, will receive a severe beating. But the one who did not know and did what deserved a beating will receive a light beating. For everyone to whom much has been given, much will be required. And from the one to whom much has been entrusted, even more will be demanded." This is the truth. Peace be with you.
Praise and blessings to Jesus Christ, our Lord and God, for giving us his words to life.
Please be seated.
Some people yesterday came by a dog sled. They reached the place pretty well. But I think many people decided, "Oh, we'll come on a nice sunny Sunday like today." Some of us, I think, who have been in Waterville for a long, long time, remember one particular priest who helped St. Joseph's quite a bit. His name was James Gower. He had been in the Navy for many years, and he had decided to be a priest. And he's from Bar Harbor originally, but he was assigned to Waterville for a long time. And so he made so many friends, and he helped a lot of people who had trouble, especially with alcohol. And then there was an interim here in this parish. I wasn't around, of course. In those days, I was very far away, where it's nice and warm. He was actually assigned, I believe. I think Swisher Mitchell could tell us more about this. Even though he was helping out in the Roman parish there, Sacred Heart, he was assigned here for some time to help out. And so we're very thankful. He died a few years ago, and then Deacon Peter Joseph and I drove to a parish where he was living in Bar Harbor for his funeral, and there's a huge turnout. He also helped set up the College of the Atlantic to get it started and get it, got all these other people from other countries to come to study environmental science and all these other things that they teach us. So we're very thankful for Jim Gower, for Paul Love, Father Paul Corey, and all these other priests who helped us in some way. And so we pray that those who who come after them do not become functionaries or bureaucrats, you know, sometimes. There's something about what they call a functionary in other languages where you just do the thing because it has to be done. And there's no panache, there's no charism, there's no life-giving movement, even though we all speak the same language. Sometimes the bodily language is not really close to what Jesus taught, especially from the gospel today where he says, if you don't expect the master around, then you can kind of take advantage of the people around you. And so that's always a great danger that we pray. Another thing is that if some of us have been, I haven't been, unfortunately, I always want to go. I go to Augusta quite often to help out in the parish. And I remember it was a snowy day like yesterday, a few years ago. I managed to get there and I managed to come back. It's not that far, but it was tough. The roads are not that well plowed. But there is a museum, a state museum, I believe, all kinds of things from way, way back in the old days. And one of the things that people mention is there a dictionary there that was written by someone living in Norridgewock, well, Madison, I guess, today, alongside the Kennebec River. He was a missionary from France, I believe, and he was learning the language of the Abenaki, and then he was translating the language and teaching them the Bible, and then, of course, he was very close to the people and traveling up and down in his canoe. But then the big shots from Boston, thinking that maybe they would be losing a lot of their territory on the northern frontier, they came up and attacked the Indian village in Norridgewock near the river, the Abenaki, and so many people were killed. We don't know. I guess nobody wanted to know in those days, and they just kept it quiet. It was a terrible history. But then some of the stuff that he did, dictionary especially, and the proverb that he wrote down from the Abenaki language, is still in the museum in Augusta. And he was killed along with all the people there. And the rest of the people who were not, who had been hunting, actually many of them were fishing, were not in their village in Norridgewock. And so they decided, oh no, this is too dangerous. These people from Boston are coming up. So they moved up the river. That was the 95 of those days, of course. And they went up to Canada. They're still there. Descendants are still there, the Abenakis. Now, of course, they speak different languages, but yet their language is recorded. And so we pray for priests today in this liturgy that we have and the people before us. And so we want to pray for everybody who somehow preached the Word of God, especially to tell us about Jesus, not just a man of history, but he was really a person who died and suffered, and then rose from the dead. That's a big thing. It makes a big difference among some people. They just say he's a great teacher, he's teaching us all these parables like St. Luke today, recorded not by him himself, because his life was the real word of God, but by other people who followed him or had heard about him. And so we also take bread and wine like he did before his passion, before he suffered. And so we say, Lord, you have chosen us to be your people. Some people may not like us. It's not just the big shots from Boston or elsewhere, but there could be other people who are jealous of some things that we have done. Maybe they say our faith is still of the past, the Middle Ages or something, but yet we still use incense and we still sing in the language of Jesus himself, which is recorded, and so we still pray in the very language that he used. And we offer bread and wine, which is said, we'd rather bring maybe diamonds or gold or other these precious gems that we have, but no. And we remember Jesus because he has risen from the dead. And we proclaim that today at this time. And we also thank for the Indian priests who are here. This is one, Dominic Savio in Winslow, helping out. And there's another one I mentioned last night. He's way up in Presque Isle. And he's from the southern India, which is a very tropical place, something like Africa, actually. And then there's another one in Augusta, which I saw. I met him a few weeks ago in Augusta. And so give a little bit of homework. It's from one of the apostles or one of the disciples of Paul. Paul used to travel a lot because the church is really a missionary from its very nature. And so sometimes it was different places and very hard to go. So he was probably afraid to go because there's so much controversy. So he'd send his good friend, Timothy. His mother was Jewish, I believe. His father was what they call a pagan. I mean, a farmer, a peasant. But he had language abilities. He knew Greek, which was the language of the business world in those days. And so if you have a chance, we have homework. The students are back after their Christmas vacations. So a little homework for Timothy. He's written two letters in the Bible. He may have written many more, but they're not recorded in the Bible. They're lost somewhere. And so, 1 Timothy, the first letter, has a second letter, but 1 Timothy, it's in your bulletin, chapter 4, verse 1 to 16. It's about being close to Jesus. Nothing to do, it says, and I quote, have nothing to do with godless myths of the day or old wives' tales. That's mostly, I guess, one way to say the gossip of the day. Train yourselves for true religion, and we, disciples, have put our trust in the living God, and He is the Savior of the whole human race.
Not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things proceeds from the Father and the
Son, who with the Father and the Son is glorified and glorified, who is Lord of the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We confess all matters of the forgiveness of sins, and look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and life of the world to come. Amen.
Anaphora of the 12 Apostles.
Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Merciful and holy Lord and Father, through your only begotten Son, you have prepared this bridge of banquet for us. Accept the offering of this bloodless sacrifice and grant us the gift of your Holy Spirit. Make us worthy to give one another the greeting of peace with pure hearts and divine love, that we may raise glory and thanks to you, to your only Son and to your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Peace to you, O altar of God. Peace to the holy mystery placed upon you. Peace to you, O server from the Holy Spirit.
Let each one of us give a greeting of peace to his neighbor with love and faith, which is pleasing to the Lord.
Eternal life.
Amen.
In a similar way, over the chalice of wine mixed with water, he blessed and sanctified it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which will be poured out and given for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins and for eternal life."
Amen.
Whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you do so in memory of me until I come again.
We remember your death, O Lord. We profess your resurrection. We await your second coming. We implore your mercy and compassion. We ask for forgiveness of sins. May your mercy rest upon us.
O Lord, lover of all people, we remember your plan of salvation, and we ask you to have mercy on your worshipers and to save your inheritance when you appear at the end of time to reward all people justly according to their deeds. For this, your church implores you and through you and with you implores your Father, saying,
"Have mercy on us, Almighty Father. Have mercy on us."
O Lord, as we, your sinful children, receive your graces, we thank you for them and because of them.
We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we profess our faith in you, and we ask you, have compassion on us, O God. Have mercy on us and hear us.
The living Holy Spirit descends and rests upon this offering for our sanctification. Let us stand with reverence as we pray.
Hear us, O Lord. Hear us, O Lord. Hear us, O Lord. May your living Holy Spirit come and rest upon us and upon this offering.
Hear ye, O Lord. Kyrie eleison.
That by his descent we may make this bread the body of Christ our God.
Amen.
And make the mixture in this chalice the blood of Christ our God.
Amen.
May these holy mysteries be for the forgiveness of sins, the healing of souls and bodies, and the strengthening of consciences, so that none of your faithful may perish. Rather, make us worthy to live by your Spirit and lead a pure life, and we raise glory to you now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
We offer you, O Lord, this divine sacrifice for your church, especially for our fathers and shepherds, the Bishop of Rome, Pope Francis, and Patriarch of Antioch, and Gregory, John, our bishop, and all the bishops of the true faith. With blameless lives and in purity and holiness, may they guide your church and present to you the faithful people who honor your name. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, your people here before you, especially those who presented these offerings. Forgive them so that they may always live blameless lives in your presence and recognize the blessings that you bestow upon them. For you are good and rich in graces, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, civil leaders throughout the world, that they may stand for justice and establish peace. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for all those who struggle with chronic illness, anxiety, and pain in their lives, that they will find healing and comfort in the Lord. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for peace throughout the world, especially in the Middle East and Africa, and an end to war and all acts of violence and hatred. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, all those who have pleased you from the beginning,
especially Mary, the Holy Mother of God, the prophets, apostles, martyrs, and confessors, John the Baptist, Stephen the Archdeacon, St. Joseph, St. Jude, and St. Mary, assist us through their prayers and make us worthy to rejoice with them in your kingdom. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, the fathers and teachers of the true faith who have endured sufferings for the sake of your church and your people. May we truly and faithfully follow in their footsteps. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, the faithful departed who have left us and have gone to their rest, hoping in you, awaiting that life-giving voice, calling them to life. Accept the offering we present to you on their behalf, and have mercy on them in your kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus, who is without sin, we hope to find mercy and forgiveness for our sins and for theirs.
Grant rest, O God, to the departed, and forgive the sins we have committed, with or without full knowledge.
Grant us pardon, O God, and forgive us and the departed, so that your blessed name may be glorified in us and in all things, through the name of our Lord Jesus Christ and of your living Holy Spirit, now and forever.
As it was, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
We have believed and have approached.
Amen.
The grace of the most holy Trinity, eternal, and co-substantial be with you, my brothers and sisters, forever.
And with your spirit.
Let each one of us look to God with reverence and humility and ask him for mercy and compassion.
Holy gifts for the holy, with perfection, purity, and sanctity.
One Holy Father, one Holy Son, one Holy Spirit, blessed be the name of the Lord, for he is one in heaven and on earth. To him be glory forever. Make us worthy, O Lord God, so that our bodies may be sanctified by your holy body, and our souls purified by your forgiving blood. May our communion be for the forgiveness of our sins and for new life. O
We thank you, Lord God and Father, and we ask that this divine communion be for the forgiveness of sins and the glory of your holy name and that of your only Son and your Holy Spirit now and forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lord Jesus, our God and Savior, you became flesh for our sake, and by sacrificing yourself, you saved us. Deliver us from damnation. Make us temples of your holy name, for we are your people and your inheritance. We glorify and honor you, your Father and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen. We stand.
Go in peace, my beloved brothers and sisters, with the nourishment and blessing you have received from the forgiving altar of the Lord. May the blessing of the most holy Trinity accompany you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, the one God, to whom be glory forever.
Amen.
I give you peace, the holy altar, and I hope to return to you. May the offering I have received from you be for the forgiveness of my faults and the remission of my sins, that I may stand without shame or fear before the throne of Christ. I do not know if I shall be able to return to you again to offer another sacrifice.